ahead.
Good evening and welcome back to Mystic Matters. We are the Greater Mystic Chamber of Commerce. Good evening, Tricia Walsh, once again.
Good evening, Suzette.
Well, what's happening now? I know we're gearing up for fall.
We are gearing up for fall, enjoying this beautiful weather and getting ourselves really right into the swing of things for our Groton Fall Festival, which is our annual event held the Groton Business Association, which is a division of the Chamber. Holds this event every year at the Saturday of Columbus Day weekend. This year it's October 11th, and that's at Pequannock Plain Park from 10 to 4. And it's a full day of family fun activities. It's free to get into. Artisans, crafters, vendors of all kinds, musicians, farmers market. I believe we have a helicopter coming in. I could
always
go on
a helicopter coming
so
in. But
we will have an upcoming show specifically for the fall festival. But in the meantime, if you are interested, you can just visit grotonbiz.com.
You know, Tricia, this is, and I've been to this event, this is the event that always wins on the weather.
Oh yeah.
And you know, the fall and winter can be just so, it's hit or miss, but every event since this started, and I think it's 11 years, it just out of the park. That weekend is it's the nicest weekend to walk around. The weather's been not too hot, not too cold. So,
which is why I chose it as my wedding weekend,
and
because I knew it had a winning streak.
And I'm going to tell you, she said that the last time, but yes, and that was, and I want to tell you, beautiful day when Tricia Walsh got married. We were outside too during the ceremony.
Yeah.
So I remember that.
I chose it specifically. I knew.
Well, you know, Tricia, this evening we always have a lot of great people on Mystic Matters, and we want to thank our viewers too, because every year someone tells Frank Ficini that we should continue it. So we continue it with the Greater Mystic Chamber of Commerce. But every once in a while we mix it up a little bit, and this evening we're going to do that for you. So we have the Corey Big Red Milton, in honor of Corey Milton, and it's a nonprofit organization. And to my right, I want to introduce Kelly Milton, the mom of Corey, and Sandy Bills.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, a very, very good
high school friend.
And Corey passed away in 2007. And I'm just going to let Kelly just tell you a little bit about Corey and what had happened that evening, or 40 days after graduation.
Mm-hmm. Well, Corey was a great kid. He was a big kid. He was 6'3", weighed 300 pounds. He had bright red hair. I'll show you his picture.
We've got it right there. We've got it right there.
All of his friends will remember him. He was just a big teddy bear. And his size was great for football, for all sports, except he was afraid he would hurt somebody. With that, after his passing, we decided to create the Big Red Memorial Fund, which helps kids play sports. We are dedicated to making sure every kid who doesn't have any money to play sports will be able to do that. So all they have to do is go to our website, fill out a form, and we will help them.
Well, you know, sports has changed quite a bit. It used to be a time where parents didn't need to have to help kids. There mm-hmm. was money available through whatever. Now it's almost a la carte. Parents are expected to pay for this. Parents are expected to pay for this mm-hmm. and this. So the memorial fund really helps, defray some of that the needs for some of the parents.
It does. On average, what we've been seeing is it takes about $200 for a young man to play in youth sports, football. And for a cheerleader, it's around $300 because they have to have special bows, special sneakers, special bloomers, special whatever. And it's very, very expensive.
Wow.
Especially mm-hmm. when you get to high school and college, the price goes up. You need special equipment. And so this fund helps other kids who don't have the ability mm-hmm. to purchase that equipment. And I think Corey would love this, have this opportunity to run by his name and have other kids play, any kind of sport they want to play without having any problems or challenges. So,
well, tell me, Sandy.
Yes.
You knew him well.
Oh, I did. Okay. I did know him well.
He's a big. You're smiling when you have the opportunity to tell about the fun, but you're also smiling when you talk about Corey. So, tell us a little bit about Corey as a friend. Mom is going to tell us everything. We know that Corey in Mom's eyes is the best kid ever. But we want to hear from you.
You know, he was the big sunshine in the group. You know, he created the environment for us. You know, he was a little mischievous, but he was a good kid. And you know, we did shot put together in track. He always was a big teddy bear, like Mom said. Like, he would come in behind you and squeeze you. You know, he was a very lovable kid. You know, everybody liked him. Everybody knew him. You know, you see Big Red come down the hallway, he'd be like, "Big Red, what's going on?" You know,
where did he get that name?
He's obviously the red hair, and he's been a big guy for forever. So I mean, the name kind of stuck. I mean, when was the first time somebody started calling him Big Red?
I think he was 6 years old. He was always bigger than most of the other kids.
6 years old.
6 years old, and he got the name Big Red, nicknamed Big Red.
Yeah, Big Red.
Wow. Well, so, and I guess, you know, obviously that's how you chose these shirt colors,
yes.
The Big Red Memorial Fund, and they are beautiful. Actually, I really do like these shirts, and I think that it's nice. So do you have, when you do your fundraising and things like that, the entire family and team, I'm assuming, comes out and wears?
We do. When we make presentations, we have the Big Red shirt. We also have a logo that we put on other t-shirts for our Big Red run. That's and we have a motorcycle run in his memory. It's generally the first or second weekend of June. It's close to his birthday. And we have a logo that's a heart and wings with a halo and the word Big Red across the heart. Wow. So.
Well, you actually have two fundraisers
We do have two fundraisers because we have a lot of kids that we try to help, and we'd like to help more kids. The main fundraiser is the motorcycle run, and then the second one is a steak dinner held around November.
Which was a huge success last year, success. And we almost ran out of steaks.
Yes, we did.
So,
And where was that held at?
It was at Stash's, right?
Stash's.
It was at Stash's, yeah.
And this year is going to be to be announced.
Yes.
Okay.
So in the fall of... Right? Is that what it is?
It'll be in the fall, and we just check our website for further details.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, Kelly, what other organizations have you helped? I mean, you have a list here, but why don't you tell the audience what...
We have helped almost all of the youth sports in the area. We have helped from Groton Mystic Falcons, Stonington Youth Football. We've helped high schools from Fitch High School, New London High School. We have helped Ledyard High School, Ledyard Youth Football. We've helped cheerleading, soccer, baseball, any youth sport you can imagine. I think the only ones we have not been able to help because nobody's asked is ice hockey.
So if there's some ice hockey fans out there or moms and dads that need some help with the ice hockey, mm-hmm. I mean, this is a fund that definitely could help.
Absolutely.
And all you have to do is just go to the website.
Just ask.
Which is what?
It's bigredbikerun.com.
Okay.
Well, I think it's just so interesting and unique that you use, you know, his two loves. Obviously, he was passionate about sports mm-hmm. and then passionate about the motorcycle, riding his motorcycle, and... you're able to combine those two loves into something that's, you know, gives back. So you're able to use, you know, the people that would be interested in the bike run to raise money for, you know, helping out the little kids with the sports. And they don't normally, you wouldn't think of them going together, but it's great that you're able to partner those in his memory and keep a legacy going.
Cool. Yeah. Sandy, how has this helped you in the healing process? I know it's 2007, but how has it helped you?
I think it's helped a lot, just not me, but our friends and our family mm-hmm. and everything. We come together every year, even twice a year, and we talk about the moments we've had with Big Red, and I think that having that cohesive helps us through the grief process with Big Red being gone. It's still hard to this day to see him gone because... Mm-hmm. You know, I still like go through my phone and Big Red's still there. Even though it's deactivated now, I can't mm-hmm. call him anymore. I just listen to that voicemail. But having our high school friends and family and other strangers coming out to support this, fund mm-hmm. and memorial and run, it puts a smile on my face. And I know that he's up there looking down on us, and you know he'd be like, yes, this is good. You know, so mm-hmm. I think it's helped us together. You know, mm-hmm. positively get through the grief of him passing away. Almost 7 years ago, so.
Well, yeah. Kelly, I've known you a long time, and mm-hmm. I know that this was devastating.
It was very devastating.
But it has helped you, too. But mm-hmm. where do you want to see this go?
I would like to see it continue to grow and get bigger and bigger than what we have now. We're helping hundreds and hundreds of kids every year. Currently, our budget is around $25,000 a year. I'd like to see that grow to be bigger. And overall, this Memorial Fund has helped us, too, because oftentimes parents, we work with area coaches, so the parents don't necessarily know who may have helped out to provide that child or their child with the funds to play a sport. And we know who we've helped and what teams we've helped, so we will go and we will watch these sports, and it helps fill our hearts knowing that we helped in memory of Corey.
Okay.
Okay.
That's really amazing. That must just be such a wonderful feeling, and I'm sure that does provide some of the healing for you.
It does.
How did you pick sports? I mean, you could have done the motorcycle, you could have done something else.
Because he was involved in a lot of sports. Okay. You know, he did track, I mean, he did football, because he's a big guy. I mean, what did he play in football? He was a lineman in football. So he's a big guy, and then, I mean, I did track my last 2 years in high school, and that's how, you know, we, you know, connected on that level as well, except for just seeing him on the field, but we did shot put, we did running together. He's an active kid, very active. You know, he's always trying to do some kind of sport or something like that, from my knowledge. So, I mean, and I think that, you know, sports in general, you know, you have to pay for everything.
Yeah. Which is sad, I have to say.
And over the years, it's more and more and more because, they're trying to add more things to equipment. Right.
And there are a lot of families out there, we all know, that just can't afford, especially if you have multiple children. I mean, and you have to do what you do for one, I mean, you try to do for everybody, the other.
Right.
Kelly, I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. So the healing process started, obviously, right away, but when was it decided that you wanted to start this fund?
We decided we wanted to start this fund almost about a month after he had passed. We had received money from quite a few people to help us with funeral expenses. Unfortunately, we did not need that money, so we took the money and we created this memorial foundation in his memory pretty much right away. And because both Corey and his brother played in a lot of sports from the time they were 4 and 5 years old, we just felt that sports would be the best to help as many as we possibly could. He was not an academic child, I should say, but we had nothing wrong with that.
He tried.
We kind of had to pull him through high school.
I think his personality just overrode that. His size and personality overrode that. You have one more picture here. I'm going to just hold this up right here. This is an interesting picture, and I want you to tell the audience a little bit about this. We've got B running over here right now, because this is probably focus in. Thank you so much, B. Where is this motorcycle now?
This motorcycle now, it is in our garage, and it has been customed. It is completely red. And his, in memory of him, is written on the side of the bike, and we have the logo for the Memorial Fund also on the bike, but it has been customed by his brother Ryan and his dad Gary.
It was Corey's bike.
It is ridden. We ride it all the time. It will never be sold. It will remain in our family forever. Mm-hmm. But it was Corey's bike, and that was one thing. He was going to Barron's Institute to become a motorcycle technician. Mm-hmm. So we kept the bike, we customized it, and it is the lead bike in the motorcycle run that we have.
Mm-hmm. So. That's unbelievable.
In the first couple of years, it was not ridden because it was needed to be fixed, but now it's up to par, and I think Gary rides it. So.
And I think it's probably important to mention that he did perish in a motorcycle accident, which is the tie-in to the mm-hmm. the bike run.
So a call that a parent does not want to ever receive. I remember, Kelly, way back when, obviously, mm-hmm. in 2007, and I was not surprised that a memorial fund would be set up in honor of Corey, just because of you.
And, thank you.
And you know, your compassion for children, obviously working full-time at the aquarium. That's how Kelly and I know each other. But I've never met your husband. And how is the family surviving today?
We're doing fairly well. We are very close. We're closer mm-hmm. than we ever were. And it's difficult, but we get through.
Yeah.
And we know we have a lot of kids that we've helped out in his memory. So it helps us tremendously every day knowing that we can help other kids.
You've said that a lot of the people don't know who gave the money.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give us, just both you and Sandy, just a story of anybody that stands out, or a group that stands out that know that you gave the money and how that affected them?
We have given so much. Oftentimes, well, there was in particular a young man most recently. He needed a pair of cleats to play football. His mom was in the hospital. Dad is not to be found. And there were three little sisters. He wanted to play football. His mom said they couldn't afford the shoes that were needed. The coach really didn't have the means to provide for him as well. So the Big Red Fund was asked if we could provide a pair of cleats. So what we did is we purchased a gift card for him from Dick's Sporting Goods, and then he was taken to Dick's. And to see that young man on the field at practice in his brand new pair of cleats was just overwhelming for us. So
who contacted you? The coach?
It was a coach.
Okay.
It was a coach.
So is it always the coaches that usually contact, or no?
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily. Like Parks and Rec, did they contact mm-hmm. us mostly? Didn't we sponsor a baseball team or something?
We have sponsored baseball teams. We sponsored Groton Babe Ruth team. We sponsored a Groton soccer team. Unfortunately, there was something with Groton Parks and Rec, and they weren't going to have a soccer league anymore, and so they were asking for soccer equipment, and we helped provide soccer equipment for those kids to play.
So, Sandy, what is the process every year? Like, it's not a given that you're going to... I asked the right question. The hair went back, and the answer... So, it's not a given every year.
No,
And is it... So, is it an online application? I mean, walk us through the process on how you get this money. I mean, do I call up and say, hey, listen, I need a pair of new shoes? You know what I mean? Well, I mean, how is that?
I mean, well, we have the site online now. It's mm-hmm. and you can get the online application there. I mean, we've come a long way from that process. They just call Kelly or somebody, or
right.
Or we have paper now. We just do mostly online.
Mm-hmm.
Correct
okay.
me if I'm wrong, Kelly.
Yeah,
but
how do you filter out who really needs it? And I mean, there's got to be some sort of credibility here.
Well, we usually work with the coaches
okay.
too. Okay, if a mom or a dad comes to us and asks us for money, we will confirm that with a coach, that they are playing for that particular team or league
right.
before money is given. And we never write the checks to individuals. It always goes
okay.
through the leagues themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then for the ride that you do in June,
mm-hmm.
how are funds raised for that particular event?
Well, we have the big red poker run.
Okay.
And so, you know, we get all our volunteers together, and you know, we have what, 3 or 4 meetings before
yeah.
the thing, and so we do detailed guidelines of what's gonna go down. You know, we go to 4 to 5, you know, 4 to 5 bars or restaurants, whatever. And
can I be on that committee?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Come on over. It's a lot of fun. Play lots of music. Me and Sam have a great time at Smokey O'Grady's all the time. playing Backstreet Boys and NSYNC and bring us in the old days.
Well, do you remember those days,
Trisha? That was actually a little
after.
Well,
I keep forgetting. That's
yeah.
right.
We play yeah. the old music, so it gives us memories.
The Backstreet Boys.
But the Backstreet Boys, yeah.
yeah.
As my dad calls them, the boys in the back street. So, I don't know. But, and then, you know, all the riders, there's no route. You can go to every bar, and then you end at, this year we ended at State Street Saloon. And it's, How much is the riders again?
It's $20 for a $20 rider,
rider
and a $5 for a passenger.
So, okay. And they all register majority at
Christopher's,
blinking out. And then they go periodically through all the bars. And then if you don't ride and you want to come in, you have to pay $10 at the door. You know, it's all going to a fundraiser, it's going to Memorial. So that's how we collect all the money from there.
Right.
We do a 50-50 raffle, and we do the raffle, and we have raffles that we give off as well that we collect money from that too. So, and then we put that in there, and we save it until somebody needs the money for it.
And typically, about how many riders are there?
How many riders did we get last year?
This last year, we had close to 300.
300.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah.
Wow. I thought you were going to say 300.
I thought 50.
No, it was close to 300.
Wow.
That's amazing. That is amazing.
Are those people that he knew personally,
no.
Just people that are involved?
They're with motorcycle groups. We advertise with motorcycle magazines, and we get the word out that way. We have advertising on radio. They'll donate advertising on radio for us, and we're able to raise the funds.
And we get the volunteers that we go out and put posters up everywhere that we can.
Now, are these shirts available if they want to buy them, or do all the riders wear the shirts if they buy them? I mean, what?
Yeah, we try to give out a T-shirt for the first 100.
The first 100 riders.
Yep. And then anybody after that can purchase T-shirts.
I had no idea.
Yeah,
that was a great question.
300 is a huge amount. I had no idea either. Wow.
Yeah. Don't we sell the coasters?
We have coasters. We have koozies. We have lanyards with Big Red Memorial Fund. People will buy all of this stuff, and it helps overall with
now,
the money too.
Do you think most of them know the story?
Some of them know the story. A lot of them don't.
Okay. All right. But they know that they're giving to a good cause.
Yes, they do.
Okay, so the cause is really what's...
That's what we want to get the
word out
for.
That's the word out that you want to mean. Obviously, he's looking down from heaven going, score, Mom, score.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Obviously, he's up there, you know, and I want to be on that committee going from bar to bar, okay? A little cafe.
We'll make sure you're invited, okay?
I just want to do that part of it, you know, but anyways. But it sounds like you've got a great group of people that are helping you and volunteering. How many volunteers do you have?
I think about 12, 15 volunteers that we have constantly since the beginning of it. We have a couple of
Now, are these friends or?
Majority of them are friends.
Okay.
Some of them are acquaintances on the process of every year. So.
Are they Fitch graduates or?
Some of them, yes. Sam. You got Natalia didn't come this year. The water course. I can go on and on.
Yeah.
You know, we have friends who have kids now that help out, you know, and then we got Mason, you know, Corey's nephew, who helps out even though he's, what, four, five? Four?
Well, obviously he knows the story now, too.
He does know the story now.
He does know the story.
Yeah.
That is truly amazing. I didn't realize the, just for that day, how many riders come out and you raise all the, and 100% of it goes to...
100% goes back to...
Nobody takes a cut out of it. That is just amazing.
Nope.
All the money.
The bands donate their time, their music, everybody. The bars donate everything to us, and they also get more advertisement out of it as well. So.
Oh, where do you advertise?
Through the radio. Right. We advertise in calendars, and then we have posters that we hang as well.
Okay.
Well, it just seems that the motorcycle riding community is so close-knit that even if they don't know specifically the story or the person, that they are willing to come out and show their support regardless. And I think that's just
really
neat.
They're very generous.
And so do you ride?
I don't, because I'm stuck at Smokey O'Grady's, which I don't mind because I get to see all the people come in and everybody's friendly.
Yep.
So we talk and then they ask about, you know, who is Corey, and then we talk, give them the story, give them the rundown. The first year it was not a poker run. The first couple years wasn't a poker run, it was run. So I actually drove in my Neon in the back of the, after all the cars went. I do ride my dad sometimes on other rides, but I mean, I'll eventually ride one of these days.
Right. Do you ride, Kelly?
I ride on the back of Gary's bike.
Okay, so that's the, now do you lead it off or do you?
No, well, see, the, on this Corey's bike, that yeah. seat was removed. So when Gary rides that, I don't have a seat in this motorcycle run.
Oh, well, we're going to have to talk to him about that.
I'll get you a little sidecar or something.
Now, you said you have a board of directors.
We do have a board,
a small board.
Small board to help oversee the 501c3 Foundation.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And it's a small board. There are 6 people on that board.
Okay, and they meet pretty regularly?
We meet twice a year.
Wow.
Okay.
And what would your, so what would your dream be? If you, you know, continue to grow like you have been, obviously, you're providing the equipment, but is there anything beyond that that you would love to see happen down the road with this fund, or are you
sticking?
I'm just hoping that it grows. I'd like to get the word out about it, and maybe we can go more than just southeastern Connecticut. We have helped, you know, one family in Pennsylvania. We've helped a couple in Ohio, but I'd like to make it grow bigger than it is now.
Okay.
Well, it seems like the word of mouth, among, like mm-hmm. I said, the biking community is going to be your almost best way mm-hmm. with that mm-hmm. whole entire group to
Well, I think you've just got a great branding.
Yes.
Big Red. I mean, how much more can you, and we're all in red this,
I mean, I know, I can't believe how
camera,
perfect
this is just perfect. Well, you know, Kelly, I've known you a long time, and I when you did, I think you were on, were you on one other time? No, you weren't.
No.
We talked about it.
Yes.
And we wish you all the success, because I know that
Thank you.
This has been a dream of yours, and also a great healing process for you and the family. So we want to make sure, Corey, Big Red, Milton, okay? So you'll be hearing more about that, and maybe we can get a little blurb as we get closer to some of the
the
fundraisers.
Yep, as soon as we know about the fall
We'll get that
event.
Date out to you. Yep. Sandy, welcome back. Well, not welcome back, welcome.
Thank you.
Fitch graduate, all of us, all three of us here, Fitch graduates, very, very proud to have graduated from the high school, and very proud to be, along with Corey, a Fitch graduate. So. Be looking out for Mystic Matters, and we're going to have some big announcements as we help move forward the Corey Big Red Milton Foundation Memorial Fund. We are Mystic Matters, the Greater Mystic Chamber of Commerce. Good evening.
Good evening.